back in, Jack. Right, in front of you, you've got three pedals. Can you name them?
One's to go.
Yeah, accelerator, yeah.
To
yeah, that's the clutch.
And one's to stop.
That's the brake, absolutely. So you've got an accelerator or the go pedal, the clutch pedal, which you use for your gears, and then the stop pedal, the brake pedal, which you use to slow down and stop. Now, have you got any idea which pedal is which?
I think
that one. It is, yeah. About the middle one.
Stop.
Yeah, that's the brake pedal, so the one on the far left must be the clutch pedal. So an easy way of remembering it is to think of ABC, but think of it backwards. So you've got your accelerator on the far right, the brake in the middle, and the clutch on the far left. And it doesn't matter whether you're in a right-hand drive car or a left-hand drive car, they're always the pedals in the same order. So accelerator, brake, and now during our lesson, I'll call the accelerator the gas pedal because it's quicker and easier for me to say. Now, we've got three pedals, but only 2 feet. So have you got any idea which foot works which pedal?
This one works the accelerator.
It does, yeah.
This one does
the clutch, yeah. And which one does the middle one then? You've run out of feet now. Yes, absolutely. Well done. So your left foot just does the clutch pedal. And the clutch pedal is the only one that you need to be able to push all the way down to the floor. So that's the one we're going to set the chair against. So you're left or right-handed? Okay, hold on the steering wheel with that hand then. And then with your other hand, reach down behind the backs of your legs and you'll feel a bar.
Yeah,
lift that bar up and then pull on your steering wheel and you want to slide your chair forward so that you can comfortably push the clutch all the way down with your left leg without being as though stretching. Okay, that's okay? Right, so now we need to set a little bit higher, okay? So, can you, if you look over the top of the steering wheel, can you see sort of like yellowy, green sort of little discs that are on the floor in front of you? No, so we need to sit a little bit higher. So reach down the right-hand side of your chair. There's a long lever down there, okay? Sway your hands on that. Start to pump that lever up. And you start to go up in the world. Keep raising your chair, keep raising your chair, keep raising it, keep going. That's it. Okay, but going higher? No? Can you see those green, can you see those little yellow discs over there? Yeah, but you need to still start stretching. So just slide that cushion underneath you. That's it, you pull it across. That's it. Push it all the way to the back of the chair. That better?
Yeah.
Excellent. Okay, right. Okay, so now what I'd like to do is reach over your right shoulder and we're going to pop our seatbelt on. And that's it. Lovely. Really good. Okay, now first of all, I just want to have steering. So I'm going to control the car with a brake and a clutch on my side. So for the time being, just keep all your feet off all the pedals, okay?
Okay.
Alright, and when we move forward, we're going to drive just over those discs, okay, onto that sort of like cobbled bit of area in front of us, and then we're going to turn to our left and follow the road around, all right?
Okay,
you ready?
Yeah.
All right then, let's go. Okay, so then just turning to your left, looking down the road, looking where you want to go, keep turning your wheel. Good, well done. Excellent. Okay, step up, that's it, well done. Good, and then we're just going to then follow the road then, as it bears round, that's it, good. Okay, and then we're going to go down towards the black fence.
Yep.
Okay, and as we get down to the black fence, we're then going to turn. We're going to then turn to our left. And then as you go down, you'll see two orange cones aside, yeah? Good. And then we've got a load of green cones. I'm going to use those as a slalom. So I want you to turn to your right and go through the orange cones.
So,
yeah, through the middle of the orange cones. And then we're going to turn sharply to our left and go through the middle of the green cones. That's it. Good. And then to your right. That's it. And through the next set of green cones. Well done. Good. And to your left again. Good. Well done. Good, really good steering. And then back to your right again. Well done. Good. Good. Well done. Good. And then through the blue cones. Well done. Good. Very good. Good. Right. And then we're coming up to a roundabout, and we're going to turn right. So you can imagine we're going to come off at 3 o'clock. So we need to keep the roundabout on our right hand side. But what I want you to do with your indicator, which is this left hand stalk, I want you to push up on it for me. That's it. Keep coming over. That's it. Push up on the indicator. That's it. Keep coming over to your left. That's it. You've got to keep the roundabout on your right hand side. That's it. Well done. Good. Right, now turn to your right. That's it. Keep turning, keep turning, keep turning, keep turning, keep turning. Looking where you want the car to be going. That's it. That's it. Well done. Good. Straighten up. Well done. Good. So what we're using at the moment is what we call the drag of the engine. And then we just turn into our left. That's it. Good. And then I want you to signal left. So this time I want to push down on it. So left hand stalk, push all the way down on it. And then we turn into our left. Well done. Good. Straight up. And if you see the two little green discs on the floor on your right hand side,
yeah.
Yeah, I want you just to drive in between those so we're going back onto the sort of like onto the bricks. Well done. Good. Right, now what we're using at the moment is what we call a drag of the engine. So we're moving around about a walking pace. Right. So what I want you to do with your right foot now is start to gently squeeze the gas pedal, the accelerator pedal. That's it, gently. That's it, gently, 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 gently. That's it, good. Now ease off your gas. Good. And then we're going to follow the road again round. Well done. Good. Good. That's it, and then all the way down to the bottom. And then we're going to turn left again. Well done. Good. Okay, now this time we're not going to go through this, we're going to go through the green cones. Straighten up. That's it. Good. I want you to now to signal left, ease off your gas, off your gas, off your gas, off your gas. Okay, pull over on, off your gas, off your gas. Okay, you bring it to a stop. Good. Well done. Alright, so well done. But you can feel how sensitive that pedal is. You don't need to press it that hard. Okay, we're only in a car park, so we don't want to be going too quickly. Well done, your steering's really good. So we're going to have a go now, you using your pedals. Alright, so you're going to be fully in control of the car. Now driving's not that complicated, but there is a lot to remember when you first start. And you have to do things in a certain order to actually make the car work. So to help us remember what we should be doing and when we should be doing things, we have a few routines. And the first routine we have is something called the POM routine, P-O-M. And all that stands for is prepare the car, so you get the car ready to want to go down the road. Then we observe, we look around, see what's happening, we're looking to see if it's safe, passing cars, pedestrians, etc. And if it is safe, we can move, we can drive down the road. So to get the car ready, to prepare it to want to go down the road, we have to find something called the biting point. You ever heard of that term? No, it doesn't matter. All the biting point means is the car is in gear and it's ready and wants to go down the road, but it can't because the handbrake's still on. And you have to find the biting point in any manual car. So that's what we're going to find now. Right, so with your left leg, what I'd like to do is push the clutch pedal, the left pedal, all the way down to the floor. And then with your left hand, move the gear lever all the way over to the left and then push it forward. So all the way to the left and push forward. Good. Now, put the clutch back down again. Okay, that's it. Push it all the way down. Okay, so keep the clutch down. Okay. What I want to do now, slowly, is start to bring your clutch up until you feel a vibration going through your chair, and then don't bring it up any higher. So just start to bring your clutch up a little bit higher, slowly, a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time, a little bit more. Feel that vibration, keep your foot on the clutch, don't take the foot off the clutch. Right, but keep it still. So keep the pressure on the clutch pedal, try and keep your heel on the floor. Okay, so you've got to take the pressure of the clutch. Okay, just squeeze that clutch pedal, that's it. You got hold of it, you're keeping it still in the same place. Okay, because if I take the handbrake down now, look, the car will move forward. Okay, so now push the clutch all the way down to the floor for me, and then we're going to pull the gear lever back into what we call neutral. So just pull the gear lever back, nice and gently, okay, and then if you give it a wobble left or right, it moves nice and easy, so we know it's not in the gear. So now you can take your foot off the clutch because the gear is not in the gear. So to prepare the car, the first part of the problem is doing what we've just done there. Clutch down, first gear, and then bring your clutch up to your biting point.
Yeah.
Then you've got to do your observations, right? Now, unfortunately, there's a blind spot down both sides of the car, and that's an area not covered by the left and the right door mirrors. So what you have to do then, is you have to look into your blind spot, which is over your left shoulder, through, left shoulder, the other shoulder, left shoulder, through this left rear side window, right? That one. Then you look in your left door mirror, which is check 2.
Yeah.
Then you look down the road, which is check 3. centre mirror, which is check 4, right door mirror, which is check 5, and then look over your right shoulder into your blind spot, which is check 6. All the time you're doing that, you're keeping your feet still at the biting point, so you're keeping that vibration going through your chair. And there are only quick checks, you're just looking for movement. Once you've done that final sweep from your left to your right shoulder, you push up on your indicator to signal right, okay, to tell people you're going to move the car to the right. Then you have another look over your right shoulder into your blind spot to make sure it's safe, and then you take the handbrake down. Now obviously to take the handbrake down, you're going to use your left hand, but you can see as I start to take the weight of the handbrake, so it starts to pull the button in on the end. So what you want to do is take the weight of the handbrake and then push the button in and push it down. It's much easier than just trying to push the button in on its own. And when it's down, yeah, so your mum will probably lift it slightly and then push it down. Okay, then put it back on again, push the button in, lift it up, and then let it lock into place. Have a little go at doing that. Okay, so lift it up, push the button in with your thumb. That's it, and then push it all the way down. It's now off. Now put it back on again, push the button in, lift it up, let go of the button. Well done. Okay, so you're going to set off now using the POM routine. So we do left leg. Right. Yeah, 25 to 11.
Okay.
Right, okay, fair enough. Okay, right, so cut all the way down to the floor. Okay, and then into first gear, so across the left and forward. Now slowly bring your foot up just so you feel that vibration going through your chair, and then don't bring it up any higher. Just bring it up really slowly, because there's a spring at the back of it. If you bring it up too quickly, it pushes your foot up. Okay, can you feel that vibration? Okay, keep your feet still. Now sweep the car now, keep your left foot on the clutch pedal. You can't take your foot off the clutch pedal, otherwise you'll stall, the engine will turn itself off. So you've got to keep the foot still where it is now. Okay, so keep that pressure on the clutch pedal. So it's going down, it's not coming any further up. Okay, now I want you to look over your left shoulder, left door mirror, down the road, centre mirror, right door mirror, and then look over your right shoulder. Good. Now I want you to signal right. I want you to push up on your indicator. I want you to have another look over your right shoulder. Is it still safe?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, take the handbrake down. So you drop the button in. Okay, now bring your pusher all the way up. Good. And then steer out following that silver car. Don't go on your gas. Take your right foot off the gas pedal for the time being. Because when you're in a tight, confined space, you only want to be going slowly, because we wouldn't get down the corner if we're going too fast. Okay, keep turning. Now straighten up, gently up. Okay, I want you to signal right, a little bit more because there's a curve on our right hand side. Okay, check the right, push up to the other side. Keep turning. Yep, good.
That's how I went like that.
Yeah? Okay, and keep following the road ahead.
Following the number 11.
Yeah. Following number 11 for the time being. Okay. And then when we get to the junction, we're going to turn left. So I just walk to the junction. No, we're not going through those this time. So I want you to signal left, so this time straighten the wheel up, push down on your indicator. Good. And then turn to your left. Okay, and you're going to keep on the black tarmac, the one with the arrows on. Okay, so straighten up and we're going all the way down. See where that 10 mile an hour sign is? We're going down there. Now, we've obviously got the car moving now, so the next thing to think about is bringing it to a stop. So obviously when you come to a stop, we use our brakes to slow down and bring ourselves to a stop. But if we just bring the car to a stop and we don't use the clutch pedal, the car will stall, the engine will switch itself off. So as we're slowing down with the brakes using our right foot, before the car's come to a full stop, we have to put the clutch down with our left leg, okay? So just put yourself a little bit further over to the left. So below that 10 mile an hour sign is a stop sign.
Yeah.
We need to stop at that stop sign, okay? So what I want you to do now is bring your right foot over onto the brake pedal, but don't squeeze it just yet. Bring your left foot up onto the clutch pedal. Left hand pedal, right, okay. Right, what I want you to do now is I want you to push your clutch all the way down to the floor with your left leg, and I want you to gently squeeze the brake pedal with your right foot. Good. Keep your foot on the brake pedal, keep your clutch down, keep your foot squeezed on the brake pedal, and then I want you to bring your clutch up to your biting point so you feel the vibration going through your chair. Okay, right. Now, come off your foot brake with your right foot. Okay, and then forward to tail. And then the car sets off. Well done. Good. And I want you to signal left, and we're going to take this next road down the middle. Signal left. Okay, we'll wait for you. Good. 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 That's it. Go. That's it. Good. Well done. Good. And then straighten up. Good. Well done. Right, and then gently back onto your desk pedal. Right, just gently, ever so gently. Just using, really, it's just like flexing your toes, really, on the end of the pedal. A little bit further over to your left, because it's a two-way course. So imagine that the centre, the white arrows are like the centre white line. You just want to keep over to the left-hand side. Okay, so we're now coming up to the roundabout. We're going to go straight ahead. So we're following where that grey car's gone. Okay. Yeah, so we've got to go slightly to our left. Don't have to signal, so just turn to our left. That's it. Keeping the roundabout on your right hand side. Well done, Jack. Good. Now signal left, so push down on your indicator. Down. That's it. Good. Well done. Very good. Excellent. Really good. And then at the junction, we're going to turn left again. Oh, excuse me.
Then right.
And then we're going to go onto the bricks again, yeah? Between those two green discs.
Yep.
Okay, so we need to signal left. Six down. Well done. Good. That's it. And then through the gap in between the two green discs on the floor. That's it. Good. Well done. Okay. So now we're on the straight, now you can start to accelerate. So squeezing the gas pedal. And as you get faster, can you hear your engine getting louder as well? Well, that's the engine telling you it's likely to do a gear change, and that's what we're going to think about doing next. That's it. Well done. Good. Okay. And then look to the head. And then start to look to your left as we make our turn. Well done. Really good. Good. And all the way down to the bottom towards the black fence. Good. And then ease off the gas again. Ease off the gas and come round the corner. Good.
Straight
ahead, yeah. Good. Try not to turn too tight because we'll keep cutting that curve with our back wheel. So then we're going to signal left and we're going to pull over onto the bridge. Well done. Okay. Good. And come off the gas. Okay, come over to the curve over on the left hand side. Okay, now straight up. Okay, good. Then move your right foot over onto the brake pedal. Speed clutch down with your left leg. Push your clutch all the way down. Push your clutch all the way down. Push your clutch all the way down. That's it. Keep your feet still. Pull the gear lever back into neutral. So it goes all wobbly. Good. Now pull the handbrake on. So lift that, let the button out, just let the button out. If you don't let the button out, it won't lock into place. So pull it up so you feel resistance, and then with your thumb, let the button out, let it lock into place. Now you can take your feet off the pedal. Okay, good. So we're going to have a go now doing a gear change. Okay, so we're going to go from first in when we're on that straight. Okay, now the gear lever is spring loaded. If I move it left and move it right, it bounces back and sits in a neutral position, which is just here in the middle of the gearbox, below three. You're warm, okay? You want to wind your window down. You see on the door, that's it, where your, no, the other button. That's it, push that button. There you go. Okay, alright. So, six just here, right? Below three and above four in the middle of the gearbox. So when we're in first gear, and we hear that higher pitch sound from the engine, we need second, yeah? Yeah? So, which is in the bottom left-hand corner of the gearbox. Yeah? But if we're not careful, if we fall back, that's it, like that, you go into fourth gear. Okay, so that's in fourth gear now. Right? Because the gear lever wants the return to the middle. So if you don't control it, that's where it's going to go, and then you pull back, you'll end up fourth gear like you've just done. So even though it's in first gear, can you see that move it?
Yeah.
A little bit further over to the left, aren't it? An extra sort of like centimetre.
Yeah.
Well, that extra centimetre is really important, because what you want to do before you pull the gear lever back is push and hold the gear lever over to the left. And then while you're holding it over the left, then pull back. And then the weight of your hand keeps the gear lever over the left, so it can only go from one to two. Right? Now, how you hold your gear lever is up to you, as long as you're using your left hand. Right? But you must hold it over the left-hand side. Okay? Now, the problem is that while you can't just move the gear lever, you've also got to coordinate your feet on the pedals as well. So when we get that higher pitched sound from the engine, the first thing we're going to do is take the pressure off the gas pedal with our right foot. Then we're going to push the clutch all the way down to the floor with our left foot. Yeah. Then we're going to pull the gear lever into second. Once it's in second gear, we're going to bring the clutch up nice and smoothly. Okay. Don't let your foot fly off the clutch pedal, because that will cause the car to stall. Once you come all the way back up again, you can then gently go back onto the gas pedal. Alright? Now, it takes a lot longer for me to tell you to do all that than it does for you to actually do it. It'll only take you a second. But the problem is, the temptation will be for you to look down and watch your hands. Because up to now, you pick a book, a phone up, or something like that, a pen. You always look at what you're about to handle or what you're about to touch. The problem with doing that in a car is your car is still moving forwards. And of course, if you're looking down, that's it. Well, more importantly, you probably won't see the car in front stop or the pedestrian stop off the road. Okay? So you've got to keep looking ahead while you do the gear change. Okay? Alright? So, when you're ready, we're going to set off again using our POM routine, and then we're going to have a go at doing our gear change when we get onto the straight. Okay? So when you're ready with your left leg, you're going to push that clutch to the floor, and then we're going to go in first gear, so across to the left and forwards. Bring your clutch up to your biting point, so if you're in first gear now, so back into first gear, got to set off in first, don't do either. Now bring your clutch up to your biting point, and so you feel that gentle vibration, then don't bring your clutch up any higher. Good, hold it still there. Now sweep your car from your left shoulder, rolling your head all the way round to your right shoulder. Well done. Good, and then push up on your indicator to signal right. Have another look over your right shoulder. Is it still clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so take the handbrake down. So yes, that's it. Good, and then steering out onto the course. Don't go on your gas just yet. Okay, because otherwise you'd be going too fast to make this corner. Good. And then at the roundabout, we're going to turn left. We're going to turn right. So push up on your indicator again. Good. Keep the roundabout on your right hand side. You've got to go round the roundabout in a clockwise motion. So you're, and that's it. Good. Good.
What's that lucky cone pack?
What's that? Oh, that we'll be doing that later on.
Oh.
There's some spatial awareness. And then we're going to signal left. Yes, we're going to go between the green cones. So we're going to signal left now. Good. Well done. Okay. And straighten up. Good. And then we're going to go over in between the green cones. Okay. And then now start to just use your gas pedal. Squeeze that gas pedal. Keep squeezing that gas pedal. Keep going. Keep squeezing. Now we're going to go into second gear. So off your gas with your right foot. Push your clutch down with your left foot. Keep looking ahead. Clutch down into second gear. Off your gas. Clutch back up. Right. Slowing it down now. Off your brake. Off your gas. Slowing it down. Slow down. Okay. The bottom, you just need to go straight ahead. So when you go up a gear, it makes your car go faster, better turn, well done, and straight ahead. Just keeping just to the left of those green cones. You can also use your gears to help slow you down. So as we come up to this corner at the top, we're going to go back into first gear. So with your left leg, push your clutch all the way down, push the gear lever back into first, good, clutch back up. You'll feel a bit of a jolt. Feel that little jolt?
Yeah.
That's what we call engine braking. So the engine can slow you down as well as your brake. And then stay up and you'll turn right again at the roundabout. So signal right, pushing up, up, keep up on the indicator. That's it, good. Good. Well done. Good. This time at the junction we're going to turn right and we're going to go up towards where that zebra crossing is, where the black and white stripes are across the road. Okay, good. So signal right, push up on the indicator. Good. Well done. Good. Okay, keep over. That's it. Now go over the zebra crossing, set the two poles to the curb. Now turn to your left. Turn to your left, just turn to your left. Turn. That's it, good. And then you're going to follow the road as it bears around to your right. That's the signal. That's it. Well done. Good. Good. Well done. And then go across. And it's gone to the left hand side of the road. That's it. Good. Well done. Good. Keep looking ahead. That's it. Well done. bed round to the right. Good. Good. Okay. Accelerating. I'm going to go in between the green disc. A little bit more gas. Easy gas pedal. In between the green disc. Okay. That's it. Good. And straighten up. And then I want you to do another gear change. So, off your gas. Foot's down with your left leg. Pull the gear lever back into second. Try and keep looking ahead. Keep looking ahead. Pull back into second gear. Good. Foot's back up. With your left leg, bring the push up. Up. Bring the push all the way up. Okay. And onto gas. Good. Well done. Right. Now I want you to gently use your brake to make the turn. So, right foot gently on your brake pedal. Good. Now ease off your brake. Good. Well done. And then straighten up. Okay, down to the bottom. Gently on your brake to make the turn. Remember, don't turn too early. Start to turn now. That's it. Good. Okay. Straighten up. Keeping to the left of the green cones with the yellow caps on. Gently back onto your gas pedal again. That's your brake pedal. Good. And then gently onto your brake again. Flip down and back into first gear. Off your brake. Good. Well done. And for the motorbike. Now back to Harley Davidson. Okay, and I'm going to turn right. Straight the wheel up, straight the wheel up. Sitting right. A little bit away from the curve. Yep, good. Turn right. Turn and turn and turn and turn and turn. That's it. That's it. Well done. Good.
We're going to the zebra crossing.
We're going to go to the right and across the zebra crossing again. Okay. And what we're going to do then is we're going to have a go at doing a manoeuvre. Okay, we're going to do a turn in the road. Okay, that's it, good. Hold on. Good. Good. Okay. A little bit further. Keep that. That's it, good. And then turn around. That's it, well done. And then a little bit more gas as you come round. Good. That's it. Well done, Jack. That's very good. Good. Then ease off your gas. That's it. And we'll cross onto the left-hand side of the road. That's it. Good. Well done. Turning. Keep turning. Keep turning. Okay. Yeah. So keep looking where you want the car to be going. Either car. No, and to your right. That's it. And then what I'd like to do now is signal right, and we're going to go into this area marked out with the blue disc. Push up on your indicator.
That way.
Yeah, that's it. Turning to your right. Keep turning. Keep turning. Looking ahead. Don't look out. Don't look at. Look forward. Okay. Not looking at what's behind us. We're going forward, so you need to look forward. That's it. And then what I'd like to do is straighten up. So turn to your left now. And we're going to keep against these blue discs on our left-hand side. That's it. Okay. And then gently brake and push down. Good. And brake on. And then pull the gear lever into neutral. That's it. Good. And then you can relax your feet on the pedals. Good. So what you're going to do now, Jack, is you're going to have a go at doing your turn in the road. It's what used to be called the three-point turn. So we're going to use first and reverse gears to turn the car around so that it's facing the opposite direction. Okay. So we've got these blue discs down the left-hand side of the car, and obviously we've got the curb there on the right-hand side of the car. Right. So we've only got the space in between the two. We haven't got a lot of space, so we need the car to use that gap up really, really slowly, but change direction really, really quickly. So we're going to make the car go very, very slowly, like a one-legged tortoise kind of speed, and we're going to spin the wheel as fast as we can, either to full right lock or full left lock. Now this car... Yeah, so right or left. Okay, and all that means is you turn the wheel as far as it will go to the right or as far as it goes to the left until you can't turn it anymore in that direction. Okay, now this car's got what we call city steering. So what I'd like to do is press that button there that says city on it, and you'll get a little red light come on. Now what that's done is made your steering even lighter, even easier to turn, okay, than it was before. Alright? So keep your wheel still, because what we try and avoid doing is what we call dry steering, which is turning the wheel when the car stood still, because it rubs or wears the same bit of tyre, like 50 pence pieces in nice round circles. So what I want you to do now with your left leg is push your clutch all the way down to the floor, and then with your left hand move the gear lever across to the left and into first gear. With your right foot now, squeeze the foot brake, middle pedal. Now bring your clutch up just to your biting point, just so you feel that gentle vibration going through your chair. That's it. Now take the handbrake down. Okay, now imagine if you're on a real road, keep the foot brake squeezed. Okay, have a quick look all the way around. Just make sure you're not about to be overtaken by anything. And then what I want you to do is take some, but not all the pressure off the brake pedal with your right foot. Just enough so the car creeps forward. And as it moves forward, I want you to spin the wheel as fast as you can all the way to the right. Okay? So ease off a little bit of brake pressure that way. Okay? A little bit off the brake pressure. Right, spin your wheel as fast as you can, really quick. Well done. And then let the front of the car go as close to the curb as you can get without actually running out. And then when you get there, I want you to squeeze the brake pedal. Can you go any closer? Good. Right, handbrake back on. Push your clutch all the way down. That's it, let go of the button. That's it, push your clutch all the way down. So you've got to try and keep your foot on the clutch pedal. Don't keep taking it off when it's in gear. Now pull the gear lever back into neutral. Okay, now we're going to go into reverse gear. Now all cars, manual cars, will have some kind of safety device to stop you getting reverse gear. Yes. So lift that collar up, that trigger button up, and then move the gear lever all the way across to the left and push it forward. Well done. Squeeze your foot brake again with your right foot. Bring your clutch up to your biting point so you feel that gentle vibration going through your chair. Okay. And then take the handbrake down. Lift it up slightly, push the button in. Then ease off your foot brake, and as you go backwards, I want you to spin the wheel as fast as you can all the way to the left. No, either way. That's it. Keep spinning, keep spinning, keep spinning, keep spinning. Ease off your foot brake a little bit. That's it. Look over your right shoulder now, behind the car. Can you see the blue discs behind us on the floor? Yeah? Let the back of the car go as close to those blue discs as you can get without actually running over them. That's it. Keep going. 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 A little bit further back. Now brake. Good. Well done. Handbrake back on again. Push all the way down to the floor. Now just pull the gear lever back and it'll jump out reverse. That's it, good. That's it, okay. And then, was it? Oh, it nipped you, that little bit, okay. Okay, you're alright. Okay, and then just move the gear lever across to the left, don't lift the collar up this time, and forwards. There we go. Right, now bring your clutch back up to your biting point. Okay, good. And then handbrake down. And then as we move forward, I want you to spin the wheel as fast as you can all the way to the right. Well done, ease off your foot brake. Ease off your foot brake just gently. That's it, good. Okay, and then brake stop. Okay, handbrake back on again. Okay, that's it, lift it, let go of the button. So when you pull it up, right, to lock it into place, you've got to let go of the button with your thumb. Okay, otherwise it won't lock. It'll just go up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down all day long. Right, so clutch all the way down with your left leg. It. Now pull the gear lever back into neutral, and then we're going to go back into reverse. So lift that trigger button up, cross to the left and forwards. Well done. Bring the clutch back up to the biting point. You feel that vibration going through your chair. Then handbrake down. Keep your left foot on the clutch pedal. Don't take your foot off the clutch. Okay. And as we move backwards, spin your wheel fast again all the way to the left. Keep spinning, keep spinning, keep spinning. Well done. Good. Keep looking around over both your left and your right shoulders. Well done, Jack. That's excellent. Then brake to a stop. Well done. And then handbrake back on again. Okay. You're going to go into pull the gear. Go with the, that's it. Now just put your hand on top and just pull back. It doesn't look like nick you that much. And then go back into first gear. All right. And what we're going to do now is we're just going to drive forwards towards that green bush that's in front of us. Yeah. Okay. All right. So push up to your biting point. And then handbrake down. Keep your right left leg on that clutch pedal. Okay. Just go forward in a straight line now. Straight up, straight wheel up, keep going forwards. That's it, good. Okay, and then clutch down and brake to stop. Okay, good. Right, handbrake back on. And then back into reverse gear. That's it. Lift that collar up, trigger button, well done. Bring your clutch back up to your bike. What we're going to do is reverse back now in a straight line towards that silver car that you can see behind us. Alright? lift the handbrake up, and then push the button in with your thumb. That's it. Then ease off your foot brake, and then going back, just look over your left shoulder through the back window. Just keep your wheel straight, plant on the steering wheel. That's it. That's it. Good. I'm just going to let the car go back. Well done. Well done. Good. Very good. That's it. Keep going. Keep going. Keep your wheel straight. Right. Gently onto brake pedal now. Good. Okay. And then handbrake back on. And then into first gear. So just pull back. Right. And then across the left. That's it. Well done. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to turn very sharply to our right. So we're going to do like a U-turn, so we end up facing back down that way. Okay. Right. So put back up to your biking point. Then handbrake down. That's it. Take the handbrake down. Well done. Good. Right. Spin your wheel all the way to the right. Keep turning, keep turning, keep turning. That's it. Well done. And then back in the car. Cut you around. That's it. Keep looking that way. That's it. Because he can see you. That's it. Good. Well done. And then straighten up. Okay. And then turn the road straight ahead. Signal right. That's it. And then just move out onto the black tarmac. And then straighten up again. That's it. Well done, Jack. Good. Okay. And then start to accelerate. That's really good. Well done. Good. A little bit of gas. Okay. But then we're going to have to come to a stop at the stop junction, aren't we? Okay. So keep in line with the silver car that's in front of us. That's it. Good. Straighten up. And then we're going to get ready to come to a stop. So I want you to move your right foot over onto the brake pedal. Push your foot all the way down to the floor. Gently on the... Sorry. Watch stop at the stop junction. So ease off your foot brake. So instead of pushing quite so hard with your foot brake, just use your toes. So foot down and then gently with the toes. That's better. And then foot back up to your biking point. Have a quick look to your right and your left. Right again, is it clear? Yeah. Off your foot brake then. Good. Ease off your foot brake with your right foot. Right, off your foot brake. That's it. And looking where we're going today. I'm going to take the first row. Good. Well done. And then I want you to drive in between the two orange cones on the floor. Down your right hand side. That's it. Straighten up. That's it. Good. Well done. And then straighten it up. Okay, then brake and put down. Okay. Okay, handbrake on. And then into neutral. That's it. Pull back. That's it. Into electrocution pedal. Okay, so we're going to have a go now doing what we call spatial awareness. So, you can see that big orange pole directly in front of us.
Yeah.
Yeah? What I want you to do is I want you to drive forwards towards that pole, keeping that pole in the middle of the car, right? And I want you to get the front of the car as close to that pole, right? But come to a stop before you hit it.
Okay.
Alright?
What if I don't hit it?
Well, try not to, because remember that's a person. Okay? So we don't want to hit it. That's a brick wall. Okay? Alright? But if you do hit it, don't worry, because it's only for family to come. Okay? Alright? Okay, but try not to hit it. This is to do with how your judgment of how big the car is, how wide it is, how long it is. Now, remember when we did our turn in the road a minute ago? Right, and we're just using our brake and our clutch, weren't we? And the car moved forward really, really slowly. That's what we're going to use now. Because we don't want to go really fast towards that brick wall, do we? Because we might end up running into it and end up squashing the front of the car, which won't be good. Right, so we want to go forward really, really slowly. So when you're ready, your left leg, push the clutch all the way down first. And into first gear, and then put the right foot onto the foot brake and squeeze it. That's it, and then bring the clutch up to your biting point, and then take the handbrake down. Good, and then ease up your foot brake, and then straight up and head towards, keep your feet on the pedal. Remember, keep the right foot on the brake, and left foot on the pedal. That's it, and when you get as close as you can, right, and then we'll brake down. Okay, can you go any closer?
Yeah.
Yeah, go a little bit closer there. Gas stop. Good. Handbrake on. So let the button out. Pull the gear lever back, clutch down. Push all the way down with your left leg. Pull the gear lever back into neutral. Okay? And we're going to have a look at how close you've got. So take your seatbelt off. Let's go and have a look at how close we've got. Thank you. Yeah. Now, because you're going to be doing a lot of twisting and turning, you can, if you want to, keep your seatbelt off a little bit.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. That's it. So close your door. Now, hopefully, if you have a look in your left door mirror, you should be able to see the left pole. And if you have a look in your right door mirror, you should be able to see the right pole. Yeah. Okay. Now, if you look over your left shoulder through the back window, you can see there's another big pole directly in the middle. Yeah, all right, we're heading towards that. But we need to go through this pole really carefully, these two poles really carefully, all right? Now, as we're going back, we might need to alter our steering to the left or the right. Now, whichever way you want the back of the car to go, that's the way you turn the wheel. So if you want the back of the car to go to the left, turn the wheel to the left. If you want the back of the car to go to the right, turn your wheel to the right, all right? Yeah. So if you want the back of the car, turn the wheel that way, to the left. If you want the back of the car to go that way, to the right, turn your wheel to the right. Okay? So clutch down, and then into reverse gear again. So clutch all the way down, into reverse gear. So that's, no, across the left, that's it. Push your right foot on the foot brake. So we're still going to go back at that nice, slow, old person's walking pace. Okay? Hand brake down, so keep your feet on the pedals. So right foot on the foot brake, left foot on the clutch. Okay, and then ease off your foot brake. Okay, looking in your door mirrors. Your door mirrors are going to be more helpful now. Okay, good. So have a look in your left door mirror. Go, that's it. Well done. Good. Have you got a gap? Can you see a gap down both sides? Okay, don't do any steering. Just let the car take you back. That's it. Are you going through them? Yeah. We've got a gap on both sides. No, we're not going to hit them, are we? No. Are you sure? What's happening on the right hand side? Okay, you're happy on the left hand side? Okay, well done. Good. Keep checking. That's it. Good. Well done. Okay, and then brakes will stop. Well done. So you can see we've only just got tiny, you know, probably about 6 inches on each side, which is excellent. It's a really good judgment. Right, and it's really important to be able to judge your gap accurately, because you will from time to time obviously have to go through small gaps.
Yeah.
But I can pretty much guarantee you that once you've passed your driving test, one of the first places you take your car to will be probably McDonald's driving. So you'll need to be able to get close to that service window, won't you, to get your Big Mac and chips. Okay? Right, now have a look over your left shoulder. Can you see the pole behind you?
Yeah.
Alright, can you see it in your door centre mirror?
Yeah.
Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to reverse back. Right, nice and slowly. Try and keep it in the middle. Right, just straight the wheel up. That's it. And I want you to get the back of the car now as close to that rear pole. Okay. Keep it in the middle. That's it. Well done. Keep your left shoulder. Okay. Straight the wheel up. Hold your wheel still. One more turn. Half a turn to the left. That's it. Good. Hold it still. That's it. Just hold it there. Okay. Just have a look over your left shoulder through the back window. That's it. There you go. Still, that's it. Good. Let the car go back and then brake. Get as close as you can and then brake and stop. Good. Handbrake back on again. Clutch all the way down to the floor. And then pull the gear lever into neutral. And then let's have a look at how close we've got the back of the car to that pole. It is. You can wind your window up. That's it. Okay, right. And then put your seatbelt back on. Okay. Well, that was really good. Nice and accurate. Very good. Alright, so what we're going to do then is we're going to go forward and we're going to exit out in between those two little orange cones that you can see on the floor on the left hand side. Alright? Okay, so when you're ready, clutch down. Into first gear. Good. And then push up the biking point. Okay, and then handbrake down. Good. Okay, but then we have to give way to some bar. So gently brake. That's set, okay? Well done.
And then we're going to stir it up.
Well done, Jack. That's very good. Good.
And let's keep following the ropes. Okay.
A little bit more gas. Come over to your left hand side. Come over to your left.
And set them up. Straighten up.
That's it. Well done. Good. And then roundabout, we're going to go straight ahead. Again, keeping the roundabout on your right hand side. We're going to go to that following left. That's the signal left. Okay, signal left as you're coming off the roundabout. Okay, that's it. So now you've signal left. That's it. Well done. Very good. 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 And then at the juncture at the end, we're going to turn left. Because the back of the car takes a tighter line round the corner than the front does. So if your front's really close, the back will actually jump over. And then turn to your right through the green disc. And a little bit more gas. Into second gear, so off the gas, push down. Left leg, pull back. Second, good. Good, push back up. Straight down, bottom. Your car, don't look at your car, because they'll, you know, realize you'll not be steering around them. Okay. Alright, good, and push up to your biting point. That's it, so push up slightly to your biting point. That's it, good. And then handbrake down, handbrake down. That's it, good. Well done. Good, and then straight up, then we turn right at the roundabout. Signal right, keep straight wheel up, straight wheel up, straight wheel up, that's it, good. Okay, signaling right, good, pushing up on your indicator to right. Good, well done. Well done, good, very good.
So, can you use a spring?
Yeah, it's just a chair, yeah, moving around in the chair. Straight a bit, not too tight, just going to tip the curve down here on your left hand side. Now turn. Alright, so you want to keep turning, you want to try and keep your car in the middle of the lane. Straight up, and then we're going to turn left at the bottom. Stick your left. Right, now turn to the left. That's it, well done. Good. Straighten up. Good. Don't do gear changes, but just accelerate. No, over onto the bricks again. Striky poles on the left hand side.
Yep.
Right, I want you to pull alongside those red and white striky poles. Okay, so get a little bit closer to them. That's it. And now straighten up. Keep going, straighten up. Keep going. Touch down and brake to stop. Okay, so keep looking ahead. Try not to be distracted what's happening on the left and right side. So handbrake on. That's it, that was up now. Pull the gear lever back into it. So we're going to have a go now. Imagine we've got two cars parked like that, and we're going to reverse into the gap in between them. So we've got the red car, and then the blue car behind it. Okay, now if you have a look in your left dormer, can you see the last red and white stripy pole?
Yep.
And you can see on top of it, it's got a little red cap. Yeah, where the chain's attached to it. Yeah, okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to reverse back in a straight line until, while you're looking over your left shoulder, you can then just see that red cap coming into view into this bottom corner of the door window here on the left hand side where my fingers are. Yeah? And when you can see that red cap, what I want you to do then is I want you to put full left lock on. Okay? So go all the way to the left that way. Okay? Alright? That's going to get the back of the car to go in towards the parking space. Yeah. Alright? Yeah, so when you see that red cap on top of that red and white pole, you're going to put full left lock on. Okay, you're going to turn the wheel all the way to the left. So that will get on the turning road, yeah? Mm-hmm. And that's going to get the back of the car to go into the space. And then if you look in your left door mirror, you'll see that the back of the car and the curb form a triangle, so a triangle of road. And as you go further and further back, that triangle of road will get smaller and smaller and smaller. Until you've gone so far in that you can't see any more road. But when you can't see any more road, you then want to start putting full right lock on. Okay, so turning it all the way to the right so you don't turn it all to the right. And that will then get the back of the car to come away from the curb and pull the finger car. But we need to go really slowly in case the car can use the spaces quickly. It sounds a lot more complicated than it is. Okay? It is quite easy, right? When you're actually doing it, it makes a lot more sense than we just throwing that through. Alright? Okay, so when you're ready, cut you all the way down and into reverse gear. So lift that trigger button up, cross to the left and forward. Squeeze your foot brake with your right foot. Okay, and bring your foot up to your biting point. Let's see if you're at vibration. Well done. Now take the handbrake down. Set. Okay, ease off your foot brake and just let the car go back. Set. The wheel back to straight, keep looking over your left shoulder through the side window, the door window. Now, can you see the top of the last red pole?
Yeah.
Yeah. Full left lock, turn the wheel all the way to the left, that way. Keep turning. Good. Well done. Okay. Right, so look at your left door mirror now. Can you see how the back of the car and the curb forming that triangle road? Yeah? And it's getting smaller, isn't it? And when you can't see any more road, you'll see road as you lost sight of it. Now, full right lock. Keep turning, go all the way, keep turning, all the way to full right lock. Ease off the foot brake a little bit, that's it, good. There we go, and then brake and stop. And brake off, there you go. Perfect, told you it was easy, I told you. Right. So, things in driving, alright, sound a lot more complicated when you try and explain them than it is when you do it, okay? So then back into first gear. Just pull it back, make sure you don't get my congestion, and then that's it, good, and then that's it, good, and then turn, that's it, good, and then we're going to keep following the road straight ahead. Well done, Jack, that was really good. And then keep following the road straight ahead, good, up to the roundabout, and then we're going to go straight ahead of the roundabout. Turn left, but we're not going to go through those green distances. Alright, so as you start to turn, start to look down the road, look where you want the car going, turn your wheel, keep turning to the front of the car, start to point where you want to go. That's it, move straight up, good, and then signal left, good, okay, and then start to turn, okay, that's it, good, well done, and then straighten up, good, and then go straight ahead, and then we're going to park then. Road straight ahead, and we're going to park just before that number 7 car, which is the first black car. So ease off your gas, okay. So what I want you to do is come slightly to your left, okay. Right. A little bit further, okay. Set, we're just going to drive over those, well not over them, but in between those yellow cones. But what we can do now is turn your wheel all the way to the right. Turn. That's it, good. And then gently brake, good. Okay, and then into reverse gear. So, into neutral. Right, into neutral first, then lift the collar up, cross it, that's it, okay. And then we're going to reverse back, and as we reverse back, tip the canoe over your shoulder. That's it, good. Well done. Right, now put your wheel straight. So one full turn of the wheel, that's it, there you go. Looking over your left and your right shoulder as you're going back. Well done. Keep checking, keep looking. Well done. Keep going back. And then brake to stop. Well done. Handbrake. And into neutral. That's it, so full gear lever into neutral. Well done. I'm just going to keep the engine on a little bit longer so we just get the briefing done. On your video. So this is your driver's diary,
yeah.
So you want to bring this with you every time you come, because that way the next instructor can look at what you've achieved and can move you up through the various levels. So level one is all about sort of like setting up your car, your seat, your mirrors, making sure that you're in neutral before you start the engine, doing your POM routine, making sure it's safe to set off, right, stopping, right, and your steering. You did really well with all of those things, and I would have thought without too much difficulty you could get those signed off on your next go. Now this is what we actually did in the lesson. Yep, so we talked about our POM routine, which stands for prepare, observe, and then move, P-O-M, we did a gear change. 2-1, we did a turn in the road, and we also had a go at doing parallel park, and we also worked on our steering, sorry, road positioning, a little more practice on steering and pedal coordination. Remember, you've got to keep that feet on the pedal, okay. But apart from that, you did really well, excellent. And then move on to complete level one. Okay, so all we've got to do now is we've got to turn the engine off. But remember, before you open your door when you get out, always have a check to look over your shoulder on the right hand side to make sure you don't open the door and knock a cyclist over. But well done, doing really well, Jack.